Thank you. அபிவிருத்தாய் வாழ்த்து.
Yet Gyaniji to render the college prayer. Request our principal madam Dr. T.K. Avvaikothai to welcome the chief guest of 48th graduation day, Shri M. Vekkaya Naidu, former vice president of India, with a bouquet. Madam, please. Now I request the controller of examinations, Dr. P.V. Kumaraguru, to present the book as a token of respect to our chief guest. Sir, please. Humble request to our General Secretary and Correspondent, Mr. Manjit Singh Nair, to present the memento to our chief guest. Sir, please. Thank you, dignitaries. Now I invite our General Secretary and Correspondent to officially declare the formal commencement of the program. Sir, please.
I declare the graduation day open. The graduation of the college has been called to distribute the degrees in various subjects of the college upon the candidates who in the examination recently held for the purpose have been certified to be worthy of the same. I invite the principal, Dr. Avay Kodai, to deliver the welcome address and present a report on the activities of the college.
ஒருவைக்கண் தான் கற்ற கல்வி ஒருவர்க்கு எழுமையும் ஏமாப்புடைத்து. திருக்குறள். ஒரு பிறப்பில் கற்ற கல்வியானது அப்பிறப்பிற்கு மட்டுமல்லாமல் ஏழு ஏழு தலைமுறைக்கும் பாதுகாப்பாக அமையும். அனைவருக்கும் வணக்கம். குட் ஈவினிங் டு ஒன் அண்ட் ஆல் பிரசன்ட் ஹியர். ஐ ஃபீல் ப்ரிவிலேஜ் டு வெல்கம் த சீஃப் கெஸ்ட் ஃபார் த 48th கிராஜுவேஷன் டே ஆஃப் குருநானக் காலேஜ், த ஆனரபிள் former Vice President of India, Padma Vibhushan Awardee, Thiru M. Venkaiya Naidu. Sir, we are highly fortunate and greatly honored with your gracious presence today for the second time in our esteemed institution for the graduation ceremony. Thank you very much, sir, for your valuable presence. I welcome our most respected General Secretary and Correspondent, Mr. Manjit Singh Naya, and all the Governing Council members of the Guru Nanak Educational Society. I extend a hearty welcome to our beloved advisor, Madam Dr. Manin Morais. I welcome the Regional Joint Director of Collegiate Education, Dr. Sudhar Kodi. I welcome the Controller of Examination, Dr. P.V. Kumaraguru, Vice Principal SFS, Dr. Anita Mali Setty, Dean Staff Affairs, Dr. Thirumagan, Deans of various schools, heads of various programs, and members of staff, both teaching and non-teaching. I welcome all the special invitees, guests, and people from press and media. I welcome the parents of the graduates and all the young graduates who are eagerly waiting to get their degrees. Welcome one and all. Now, I take the privilege of presenting the report about Guru Nanak College and its activities. The Guru Nanak College was established in 1971 by the Guru Nanak Educational Society with 6 sections of pre-university and 3 UG courses in mathematics, chemistry and economics with 450 students, and today it has blossomed into a full-fledged PG and research institute with 27 undergraduate, 9 postgraduate, 8 PhD programs and 82 skill and value-added certificate courses with a student strength of around 7,200 and 450 staff members, which includes both teaching and non-teaching staff. The motto of our colleges, pro bono publico, which means for the benefit of all. The college is affiliated to the University of Madras. The University Grants Commission granted autonomy to the college in 2015. The college is accredited at A++ grade by the National Assessment and Accreditation Council, that is NAC, with the highest CGPA of 3.68. The college is ranked in the 82nd position by NIRF and is ranked among the top 100 institutions at the national level by various agencies like India Today, Education World, and The Week. The Guru Nanak College has certain unique features. To name a few, we have a temple of worship, that is Gurudwara, in our campus. We have the best practice of having the college assembly every Monday, which starts with Tamil Thai Vaalthu, followed by our revered Gyaniji rendering the college prayer, invoking the blessings of the Almighty. The proceedings of every week's assembly is taken care of by the various departments, one after the other. The assembly is attended by all the students and staff. Another unique feature of our college is that we have a langar kitchen in our college, which serves free meals for 750 students every day. The Guru Nanak College has received a number of awards. To name a few, it has received an award from the Penn Trust for outstanding long-term contribution for women safety. We have also received the Academic Partner Excellence Award from ICT Academy for training highest number of students under student certification program. We also received an award from NASSCOM for highest number of NASSCOM certification. I feel privileged to say that Guru Nanak College is the first arts and science college for receiving the Cisco India Excellence Award for highest number of certification. I take pleasure in saying that Mr. Manjit Singh Naya, our dynamic general secretary and correspondent, has been awarded the Education World Grand Jury Award 2024 for his exemplary leadership. The Education World Grand Jury Award 2023 was awarded to him for his extraordinary contribution to local community. The college has signed various MOUs with national and internationally reputed organizations such as ISIPCA, CIPET, NASSCOM, SAS, Maruti Suzuki, MGM Cancer Institute, Institute of Caste Accountants of India, and so on. The college has an excellent infrastructure with 8 academic blocks with state-of-the-art facilities, smart classrooms, well-equipped laboratories, skill labs, microbiology labs, production labs, and so on. The recent addition to the infrastructure is the Shahid Bhagat Singh Sports Complex and Saragari Shooting Academy, inaugurated in December 2023. The total built area of the sports complex is 60,000 square feet. It has shooting ranges with 24, 28, and 40 electronic targets, respectively. For academic administration, we follow the school system. We have 6 schools, namely School of Languages, School of Humanities, School of Sciences, School of Commerce, School of Management, and School of Information Technology. The school system focuses on the development of qualitative academic curriculum and gives importance to student-centric learning. We have 6 different centers of excellence: the Guru Nanak Center for Research, Guru Nanak Center for Skill Development, Guru Nanak Center for Innovation and Incubation, Guru Nanak Center for Consultancy and Outreach Initiatives, Guru Nanak Media Center, and Guru Nanak Center for E-Governance. The Guru Nanak College excels in research activities. The Guru Nanak Center for Research offers PhD programs in 8 disciplines with 26 research supervisors. Till now, 244 PhDs have been awarded, and we have 49 patents till date. We have the Guru Nanak Journal of Multidisciplinary Journal, which is a biannual ISSN journal which focuses on publishing quality research articles. The Guru Nanak Center for Skill Development functions effectively, and it offers 82 skill courses to the students. 42,000 certificates have been successfully issued over the last 4 years under the banner of skill development. The Guru Nanak Center for Innovation and Incubation functions effectively and produces a number of bio-friendly products such as soaps, hand sanitizer, lip balm, mosquito repellent, biodegradable herbal sanitary napkins, and so on. Next, it's about the Guru Nanak Center for Consultancy and Outreach Initiatives. The distinctiveness of Guru Nanak College is in its outreach initiatives. Under GNCCOI, we have a medical center, a police well-being center, Swabodhini School for Special Children, Pen Vudayal Padai, and a crush named Nanak Vatika to take care of the children of the staff. The Guru Nanak Media Center documents the in-house and external events of the college and highlights it in social media, print media, and the college newsletter, Campus Samachar, and it also manages the contents of the college website. The Guru Nanak Center for E-Governance takes care of the entire database of the campus and ensures a paperless campus. We have a number of student support services and extension activities such as NCC Army Wing, NCC Air Wing, National Service Scheme, that is NSS, Enviro Club, Fine Arts Association, Women Development Cell, Entrepreneur Development Cell, Citizen Consumers Club, Internal Complaints Committee, and so on. The college has organized a number of seminars, conferences, workshops, hands-on training, etc. during the academic year 23-24, and the number of events organized comes to a total of 296. Here, we have a glimpse of the various conferences and workshops organized during the year 23-24. Next is about the sports activities of the college. Our students excel not only in academics and extracurricular activities, but they excel in sports as well. Here you can have a view of our exemplary sports achievers. We have an excellent training and placement cell which caters to the job requirements of our students. Here we have some of our top recruiters. In this 48th graduation day of the college, the college has produced 2,061 graduates. This graduation ceremony is for the second batch of 663 students. The overall pass percentage of the year is 93.38%, out of which 99 candidates are rank holders. Before I conclude, I offer my warmest congratulations to our graduates. Dear graduates, your hard work, perseverance, and dedication have led you to this moment. As you move forward, remember the values and lessons you learned from this great institution and strive to live as responsible citizens of our country. Congratulations to all the graduates once again, and thank you very much for this wonderful opportunity.
Thank you, Madam. Shri M. Venkaya Naidu is a renowned Indian politician. He was the 13th Vice President of India from 11th August 2017 to 11th August 2022. Naidu served as the Minister of Housing and Urban Poverty
Development and Information and Broadcasting in Prime Minister Narendra Modi's cabinet. A well-known leader of Bharatiya Janata Party, he has also served as its national president from 2002 to 2004. Earlier, he was the Union Cabinet Minister for Rural Development in the Atal Bihari Vajpayee government. He was active in politics since his college days. Naidu was associated with the Akhil Bharatiya Vidyarthi Parishad, the student wing of the Rashtriya Swayam Sevak Sangh. He is known for his oratory skills and command over several languages, including Telugu, Hindi, and English. Advocate of agricultural and rural development, emphasizing the need for modernizing rural infrastructure. Strong proponent of cultural heritage and traditions, often promoting Indian languages and culture. Known for his love for literature, he has a keen interest in reading and has authored several articles and papers. Venkaya Naidu is remembered for his contributions to rural and urban development in India and his efforts to strengthen parliamentary democracy. His tenure as Vice President and Chairman of the Rajya Sabha was marked by significant efforts to enhance legislative efficacy and productivity. Our chief guest journey from a student leader to one of the highest constitutional positions in India, reflecting his dedication to public service and development. The graduates gathered over here are eagerly waiting for his presidential address. Without much ado, I now request our principal madam to formally invite our most distinguished chief guest to deliver the 48th graduation day address. Madam, please.
The chief guest, Padma Vibhushan Shri M. Venkaya Naidu, former Vice President of India, to deliver the 48th graduation day address. Sir, please.
Guru Nanak Kalurian Chedalar Thiru Manjasingh Nair, Guru Nanak Kalurian Mutalwar Dr. T.K. Avai Kothai, Guru Nanak Kalurian Thiru Kattu Patrar Dr. P.V. Kumaraguru, Guru Nanak Kalurian Thunai Mutalwar Dr. Anita, Vanakkam, Sat Sri Akal, Namaskar. Guru Nanak Kalurian Panvilavil Van Vangaldan Kalandu Kaludil Mikil Magilchi Adikiren. I feel really happy and honored to be here amidst you all today for the College Day function of this prestigious institution of Chennai, Guru Nanak College. Members of the Managing Committee, Principal, respected teachers, distinguished guests, and parents, and my dear students. Sat Sri Akal, Vanakkam, Namaskar. It is my second visit to this prestigious institution once again for a graduation ceremony where you will be conferred with your respective degrees. I consider Guru Nanak College to be a true temple of learning because of the spirit of service which guides it. It is not only a premier institution striving hard to impart knowledge and nurture the minds of young students, but as a larger vision and mission of service to society. This reflected in the motto of the college, which is pro bono publico. A translation of the Sikh prayer, Sarbada Vada, for the benefit of all. Great, noble motto. If you are guided by such noble thoughts, you will achieve success exceeding your own expectations as individuals and as an institution. My dear young friends, I would like to make this opportunity into a memorable occasion. And I first congratulate all of you on reaching this significant milestone in your lives and careers. A special word of congratulations to all toppers and gold medalists. Needless to say, you are an immeasurable, you owe an immeasurable debt to your gurus. Gurus have equipped you with knowledge and education, which will shape your careers and lives. Our Rishi said, knowledge is the supreme wealth. Vidyadhanam sarvadhanam pradhanam. Your college is a center of educational excellence. The fact that all of you, both teachers and learners, can take pride together, you have built a magnificent institution, both in terms of education as well as infrastructure. All of you are also aware of the fact that your future is directly connected with the future of our great nation. Remember that education holds the key to national development. This fact assumes added significance in India, the fifth largest economy in the world, was to become the third earlier than expected. We are going to become the third largest economy in the world, where over 50% of the population is below 30 years of age, and more than 65% of the population is at 35 years of age. Bharat is seen as the future talent factory of the world, with the largest pool of human resources. India is also set to go past coveted to 5 trillion mark earlier than expected. In fact, it is seen as the growth engine for the global economy, and all of you are part of this growth story. The nation is counting on you in driving this developmental trajectory, and your future in turn depends wholly on education. This is where education you have received here assumes significance. My dear young friends, the other aspect we'd like to look at this important role is the technology in playing in democratizing education and taking learning to the last mile. The last adoption of technology in education along with the IT related revolution in India has come to at a time whenever the youth are leading in innovation, launching successful startups, building unicorns, and contributing to economic growth. In the golden period of Amrit Kal, and we take education to the last mile, the untapped potential of the students can be harnessed for the larger good of the country. It is my conviction that education should empower, enlighten, emancipate each one of you. Education is not for simple degrees. Education is to empower. Education is to enhance your knowledge. Education is to enlighten. Regardless of which stream you belong to, only when there is such awakening in the collective consciousness of the youth of a nation can development be fast-tracked and the nation move towards as one. The other important aspect I always stress upon is the need to fully democratize education. It is my firm belief that quality education must become accessible and affordable to all. Accessible and affordable to all. I commend the management of this prestigious institution for helping and supporting needy, meritorious students through scholarships and number of initiatives. The commitment of this college is to social responsibility is evident through the various outreaching programs as well, from self-defense programs for women students, blood donation camps and health camps towards environmental awareness campaigns and educational programs for the underprivileged children. Your college seeks to actively engage you with the community and create a positive impact on society. I am pleased to know that there is a police well-being center in the campus for psychological counseling of policemen and their rehabilitation. Similarly, I am glad to learn that the management provides nutritious and tasty food to 700 students every day through langa in the Gurudwara. The other beneficiaries of the langa, I am told, include the NCC cadets, sports persons and volunteers. All these efforts are truly worthy of appreciation. My dear students, education which you receive here must empower you with a sense of responsibility towards the society. As Swami Vivekananda had rightly said, and I quote, "We want that education by which character is formed, strength of mind is increased, the intellect is expanded, and by which one can stand on one's own feet." This is what great Vivekananda has said. Strive hard to become well-rounded personalities equipped with holistic education. dream, aim, dream high, aim high, work hard, you will definitely reach heights in your life. I am pleased to learn that Guru Nanak College has established several centers of excellence that promote research and innovation in disciplines, the biotechnology, the environmental science, and the social sciences. The underlying mission of the center is to foster collaboration with the leading institutions and industries. This is important because it ensures both the students and members of the faculty are at the forefront of scientific and technological advancements. My dear students, this Guru Nanak College provides a healthy learning environment that combines academic precision with an area of co-curricular and extracurricular activities. I would urge all of you to take up sports activity, yoga, game, or any form of exercise, also meditation. Everybody must indulge in physical activity. If you are physically fit, you will be mentally alert. Remember this. Whatever physical activity you choose, any game, jogging, running, or even walking, any of these activities will enhance your endurance. Keep this in mind. I would urge upon the youth of the country that they must practice getting up early in the morning. Rise with the sun, not your sun. And then complete your work by the sunset. Because nowadays the children are getting used to the electronic gadgets, spending time unnecessarily more than required, and then it disturbs their night sleep. If you don't go to bed early, then you can't wake up early in the morning. Keep this in mind. It's always good for a healthy person to get up early in the morning, fresh. I am now 75. I go to bed at 10 o'clock, thanks to Vice Presidency. Earlier in politics, I used to go to bed by 12 o'clock in the night. But after becoming Vice President, there is a protocol. They won't give any program after 8 o'clock. So simply by 9, I go to bed and get up by 4:30 in the morning. Half an hour or 1 hour, I go through traditional music. That really makes you fresh. That really empowers you. That starts you with a good thinking, with a positive thinking in the morning. Music has great power to empower you, to enhance your knowledge, to give you good thoughts, to energize you further. So keep that in mind, and every student must get up early, practice whatever you want to have, meditation, including yoga. One boy told me recently, and I was advocating yoga, he said, "Yoga is good, sir, but yoga is Surya Namaskara." I understood. I told him, if you have problem with Surya Namaskara, you do Chandra Namaskara, no problem. Surya Namaskara or Chandra Namaskara. Yoga has no religion. It is above religions. It is an exercise given to us by our forefathers, by rishis. That empowers you. Some people say, sir, Modiji, definitely Modiji has taken it to the United Nations thanks to his initiative. Now 172 countries, they are practicing yoga. Yoga is not because of Modi. It is for your body. You have to understand this. The Prime Minister, of course, has taken it to the United Nations. But this is there since times immemorial in our culture, in our heritage. So practice yoga. That improves your concentration. That enhances, as I told you, your energy levels. That gives you positive thinking. That is one thing. Second is, as I said, physical fitness. If you are physically fit, you will be mentally alert. The third important thing the students and the youth of the country must practice is back to our roots. Spend time with grandparents. They are the teachers. They have a lot of knowledge. They will tell you about our culture and our heritage and our great forefathers. So try to be spending some time with the grandparents and then with parents, of course. And then try to spend some time with the nature. Nature is very important in everybody's life. Nature. The sun, the moon, the water, the land, and the air, they all give you extra strength. So that's why I urge upon the youth, nature, culture for your bright future. Nature, culture together for bright future. This should be practiced by one and all. This is very important in life. And another simple advice I want to give all the youngsters is, eat Indian food. I'm not giving you any food code. You eat vegetarian, non-vegetarian, or even both also, I have no problem. But we must eat proteinous food. We should avoid junk food. Unfortunately, because of westernization and the influence of TV and other things, children are getting used to the junk food. And one boy told me, sir, fast food, sir. Fast food. And fast food, of course, fast food will go fast also. And he told me, sir, it is instant, sir. Food cannot be instant. I told him, if instant means constant disease. You have to understand this. The food cannot be instant. It has to be cooked properly. So try to eat proteinous food. Cereals, millets, and of course, I need not tell to the Sikh community, of course, they eat always nutritious food. That's why they are strong. Follow their example. This is another simple advice of mine. And then have developed a social outlook. Share and care is the core of Indian philosophy. Share and care. Sarve jana sukhino bhavantu. The entire universe is our family. That attitude should develop. We must always think, irrespective of caste, creed, sex, religion and region, we are all Indians. We are all Bharatiyas. This spirit should be there in everybody's mind. We should not differentiate people on the basis of caste. Great, go through Guru Nanak Ji's teachings and preachings. They will provide you valuable guidance how to conduct yourself as an ideal human being. The teachings are very sacred and they will be very useful in guiding you in a proper method. Go through those teachings. You go through Bhagavad Gita, go through Ramayana, go through lot of our literature. They are all of practical knowledge givers to all of you. Go through these religious books. I am not suggesting you to go through particular religion. Religion is way of worship and way of prayer. You do whatever it is. But remember that our culture is one. We have to follow Indian culture. And we have to show to the world we are Indians. We are Bharatiyas. As I told you, irrespective of caste, creed, sex, religion, we are all Indians. This should be there in the mind of everybody. And try to inculcate good habits, try to make friendship with as many people as possible, become a social conscious person. And then think about the country. Think of yourself, think about your family, think about your native place, think about your surroundings, then think about the state and the country also. I always suggest in every meeting with youngsters, even after becoming vice president, even after relinquishing my duty as responsibility as vice president, I continue to go around the country, meeting people, greeting people, talking with people, walking with the people, spending time with the younger generation. That is my favorite past habit. That's why I said, I am retired, but not tired. Going around, meeting youngsters, sharing my thoughts with them, taking feedback from the younger generation. What is their expectation? What are their thinkings? And then trying to mold them into ideal citizens. That's, I have taken it as, education is a mission, not for commission. There should not be any remission or give any omission. It should be like passion for the sake of the nation. This has to be understood by one and all. And I am very happy that the Guru Nanak College, for that matter, Sikh community across the country, they run educational institutions as a mission, not for commercial or business activity. That's why they are recognized for excellence in their service. So it should be taken as a mission. And that mission will be useful for us in building and strengthening our nation. My dear youngsters, remember the proud culture, as I told you. Remember the rich spiritual and cultural heritage. It is our duty to preserve, to protect, to promote, to propagate the glorious legacy to help India to regain the status of Vishwaguru. India was known as Vishwaguru once upon a time. Students from across the globe, they used to come to Nalanda, Takshashila, Vikramashila, the famous universities. They were all destroyed. With the advent of the British rule, we lost our moorings. We forgot our heritage. They thrust their education system on us. What we were taught is not Indian history, their history. That is an unfortunate thing for all of us. They have not only ruled, ruined, looted, cheated our country, they have cheated the minds of some of our leaders also. That's why that slavery mentality, colonial mindset, has come into the minds of some people. We should feel proud to talk as Indians, as Bharatiyas. We should remember the great work done by our forefathers, and we should feel proud of the same. And I am happy that the new education policy is a right step in the right direction. I urge upon all the education institutions across the country to take the spirit from the educational policy and then adapt it to the local conditions and standards. That is what is required, because every student must be proud of his heritage, her nation. They must develop national outlook, broader outlook, and you should become patriot for the sake of the country. We must be ready to do anything for the sake of country, nation. What is Desa Bhakti? Desa Bhakti do not mean simply having bhakti for that geographical India. Having bhakti and concern for all the people of the country, all the creatures of the nature. That is Desa Bhakti, taking care of all of them. And then preserving nature. If you preserve the nature will protect you. Otherwise, you are seeing what is happening, because across the globe, people neglected the nature. They played with the nature. They occupied rivers. Even in Madras, please remember, earlier, I am in this part of Velachery, there were huge floods because the river, the small rivulets, the tanks, they were all encroached upon. So there were floods were there. Nature, across the globe also, even in America, untimely rains, fire in cities. San Francisco, there was fire. natural calamities, because nature has been neglected, it's showing its fury on the people. That's why I said, let us all protect the nature. That should be part of our culture. That is for our future. So be friendly with the nature. And then we should all come out with new ideas. Students, younger generation, come with new ideas, innovation, incubation, information technology. Lot of opportunity. Now artificial intelligence also is coming. But this technology has to be properly harnessed. Otherwise it will create havoc. The children should not be allowed to use cell phone excessively. Cell phone to some extent is very helpful. But if you use cell phone excessively, it will become a hell phone. Hell. H-E-L-L. Remember this. And with the advent of cell phone and this Google and other technologies, the children are losing their inherent innovative thinking. This is a very important thing. Children should be allowed to think. They should come with new innovation rather than going by machine learning and going through that. Now you ask any child, how far is Guru Nanak College from your place? Google. Then what is the name of your father? Google. A stage may come when the youngsters are asked, what is the name of your wife? Say Google. Own thinking is going. Machine will create havoc. It will be useful to some extent. Beyond that, you should not become mechanical. You should always come out with new innovations, new ideas, positive thoughts. One must be positive. Positivity is very good, except in Corona. Corona positive is bad, of course. Otherwise, positivity is very useful. And earlier, we used to protest, demonstrations, so many things, buns and all. Earlier it was foreign regime. Now it's our own country, our own people, our own government. If you destroy public property, you are destroying your future. This has to be kept in mind. I am happy that the students' community across the country, I was also a student leader. I was school people leader. I was college union president. I was university students union chairman. Various positions are held. Those days are different. Now it is our freedom. Our own country, we must all have developed positivity. We should not waste our energies. There was time when every time there is some strike or other. There is a joke. One father, he came to Chennai to meet his son. Went to Pachayappa's college and to meet his son. All students are all outside. He asked about the students, what is happening. The student said, we are on strike. Then he asked, what is the issue? The boy said, we are on strike and the issue will be decided in the evening general body meeting. That's a joke. It's a joke. Because strike, those days, not Pachayappa College, any college for that matter. For the sake of this thing, I took the name. Don't misunderstand Pachayappa's college. Every college has got its own important this thing. So strikes and all, they should be avoided. We should all make positive contribution, positive thinking, because we are independent country, we are on our own. And children, I urge upon the children, first to practice your mother tongue. First mother tongue, then brother tongue, later any other tongue. Mother tongue is like eyesight. English is like spectacles. If you have eyesight, spectacles will be useful. If you don't have eyesight, even if you wear Ramon glass, zuban se kuch aayega nahi. So try to first promote, propagate, talk in your mother tongue. Whatever it is, Tamil, Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam, Marathi, Assami, Punjabi, Bhojpuri, whatever language, first feel proud to speak in mother tongue. I feel that basic education should be in mother tongue in the beginning. Later you can go to other languages. we must also, we should not hesitate to learn Hindi. Hindi is our national language. Unnecessary, some people they say anti-Hindi. Why should there be any antiness towards any language? Some students told me, and I was addressing a function, they told me, sir, Hindi is being imposed on us. I told them, no imposition. They clapped. Then second thing I said, first no imposition, then second no opposition. That is my proposition. It should be our position. We should learn as many languages as possible. And Hindi also will be useful. I am from Nellore, nearer to Chennai. In the younger days, I did not learn Hindi. Later on, I became already a general secretary of the party. And later became already a president. I realized the importance of Hindi because to communicate with the people. English, not even 2% of the population understand English. So you need to learn as many languages as possible. Some people have a wrong notion. Sir, unless we study in English, we can't go up. One student told me. I said, go up? Yes, sir, we can't go up. Then I told him, Babu, recently I have talked to God by dialing ISD and asked him, sir, is there any restriction to come to you? One should read only English medium. God told me, no. Once expiry time is over, anybody, they can come and reach me. The boy told me, sir, you are just making a lighter of my comprehension. Then I told him, I understand. I told him, I am telling you all students, the president of India, she did not go to convent. She studied in her mother tongue. The outgoing president, Ramnath Kovind, who has inaugurated our block, he didn't go to convent, he studied in his mother tongue. I am the vice president till the other day, second highest constitutional position. I did not go to convent, I did not go through English medium. I have studied in my mother tongue and I used to go to a village street school. Then I could become that. Then the Chief Justice of India, recently retired, Justice N.V. Ramana, a Telugu man, he said, I studied in mother tongue. Then the Prime Minister of our country, the most popular Prime Minister across the globe, India is recognized and respected now. He never went to a convent. He studied in his mother tongue initially. So base should be from mother tongue. Then later, you can learn as many languages as possible. So the people have a wrong notion. China, Russia, Germany, France, you go to any of those countries, the leaders, they do not speak English. They speak in their mother tongue. They come here to meet our Prime Minister, our President, as Vice President, I used to receive them. None of them used to speak in English. I asked the late Sushma Swaraj ji, Sushma ji, kya in logon ko angreji manu nahi hai kya? She said, no, wo jante hai. Phir, they don't want to speak in English, they want to speak in their mother tongue. And there is translation. They feel proud to speak in their mother tongue. Even China, Germany, Russia, and all those countries, even research is in their respective languages. And I would like to see in India, thanks to the Prime Minister, his initiative, the UGC, the AICT, they are now making experiments of even technological courses also in the respective mother tongues of the people. That will be easy. If you force on students, another language, they have to learn two things. First, they should learn language, then they should learn the subject. If you teach him in his mother tongue, straight away, it will go into his mind. And later, learning as many languages as possible is very easy. And you can speak in any language of your choice. So first, focus on mother tongue. Every student, every youngster, please, respect four things. First, mother. Mother who has given you the beautiful birth. We should always remember our mother. Even the country also is called as motherland. We call Bharata Mata. We don't say Bharata Pita. That is our tradition. That is our culture. Mother. Then, Janma Bhumi. Remember your native place. Even if you become something big in your life, you should visit your native place and do something for that native place, Janma Bhumi. Third thing is mother tongue, the language that has come from mother's womb, you must propagate, speak in mother tongue. The fourth thing is the motherland, the country to which you belong to. You must feel proud wherever you go. And then the guru, the gurus who taught you the education. You should always remember the gurus. Even in the age of Google, guru is very important. If there is some repair to the Google, guru has to be called. Remember that. So always remember the gurus also. These things are very important in everybody's life, particularly in the life of the youngsters. Please remember these small, small things and then move on. You have a bright future. India is now being recognized and respected worldwide. We have a lot of opportunities. Now everybody across the globe, they want to come and invest in India. Our boys and girls, we are going abroad. You see multinational companies, many of them are headed by Indians. Satya Nadella, Sundar Pichai, number of examples are there. Multinational companies are headed by Indians because that intellect, that knowledge of India is supreme than many other things. So have confidence in the future, work hard. As I told you, dream, aim high, dream high, work hard, you will come up in life. Thank you very much. Namaskar. Jai Hind. Nandri Vanakkam.
Such as perform, reform and transform. Today we got many as such, like nature, culture and bright future, cell phone, health phone and so on. Your inspiring speech is a great motivation for the graduates. Your wishes and blessings will take them to greater heights, duly assisted by their hard work and dedication. Thank you, sir. May I now request our principal madam for the announcement. Madam, please.
Let the candidates be now presented by the controller of examinations and the heads of the departments.
I now request the controller of examinations, Dr. P. V. Kumaraguru, to present his rank holders. Sir, please.
BCom Account and Finance, Hemavadi, Gold Medalist. Pooja with a Silver Medal. Neha Goswami with a Bronze Medal. BCom Corporate Secretaryship, Sri Watson with a Gold Medal, Rahul Majumdar with a Silver Medal. Prashant with the Bronze Medal. BCom General, Ishwaran Gold Medalist. Madhulika with a Bronze Medal. BCom Bank Management, Ganesh, Gold Medalist. Vasuprada with a silver medal. Reshma, bronze medal. BCom Marketing Management, Vedant Sharma with a gold medal. Satish with a silver medal. BCom Information and System Management, Menaka with a gold medal. Anushya with a silver medal. Batmaja with a bronze medal. BA English, Krishnaveni with a gold medal. Praveen Kumar, the silver medal. Dear Susan Thomas with a bronze medal. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. I request the rank holders to pose for a group photo with the dignitaries on the dais. Dignitaries. I now request Dr. J. Saranya, the program head of BCom Honors, to present her candidates. Madam, please.
Akhilesh Subramanian C. Anandu N. Nair, Balasubramani R, Dina Dayalan K, Gautam Kondaya S, Hariharan K, Harish R, Madan Babu R, Muniraj M, Nandakumar B, Pavan K, Porchelvan S, Praveen R, Ram Sudarshan R E, Rahul G, Rakshan M. Ravi B. Sanjut S. Santosh Kumar S. Siva Prakash B. Shri Ganesh H. Shri Ram B. Steffi Colin D. Sundara Rajan V. Suresh Kumar P. Tamil Chelvan P. Tanigavel V. Tarun Kumar S. Venkata Rokit P. Vignesh U. Vignesh Prabhu M. Vipin Prasad Y. Yukesh Kumar R. Thank you.
Thank you, madam. May I now request Dr. S. Amudalakshmi, the program head of BCom Accounting and Finance, to present her candidates. Madam, please.
Abhishek C. Arvind Uday Kumar M. Ashwin S. Badri Narayanan V. Bharat R. Bharat Vaibhav D. Deepak Krishna E. Deepak Kumar R. Dinesh B. Dinesh Kumar V. Esaki Raja S. Ganesh Adit B. Gokul C. Gokul Raj S. Gunaseelan K. Harikarthik C. Jagadishan N. Jagan G. Jayasurya M. Karthik S. Kaushik Venkatraman. Kuralarasan R. Lokesh D. Lokesh G. Madesh K. Mohit Kumar K. Muniyan G. Nambirajan R. Nandagopal V. Ponpandian S. Pradeep P. Praveen J. Praveen Kumar R. Priyadashni DS. Rahavan M. Rajesh K. Raveen Raja T. Ravindranathan S. Revati S. N. Sai Prashant, yes. Sai Ram, yes. Santosh P. Santosh Kumar K. Santosh Kumar J. Satyamurthy, yes. Shanmugam, yes. Subalakshmi R. Surender R. Thiruvenkata Murugan KM. Ullas R. Vaishnavi S. Venkatesh P. Venu Prakash K. Vikram K. Aarti M. Abhishek Priyan V. Ajay Vardarajan S. Amandeep V. Anand Rao GD. Anirudh M. Anup Singh B. Arvindan DS. Balakumar N. Balamurugan S. Danush Kumar B. Dhyaneshwaran J. Guru Akash S. Jagadish M. B. Kartik Raja M. Kartik S. Kartik A. N. T. Kribakaran K. Kishore Kumar D. Kishore Kumar S. Kundan Lokesh A. Manjunath Manoj Kumar B. Mukundan A. Murali Krishna D. Naresh Kumar M. Naveen R. Nishok G. V. Praveen S. Radesh Shanmuga Sundaram. Raghavina M. S. Rahul B. Rajakant K. Sai Krishna G. D. Sai Charan K. Sandhya R. Sanjay S. Sanjay M. Satish Kumar T. Shravan Shanmugam G. N. Sivahari S. Srinath R. Sriram S. Subhash R. Sunil R. Surya Prasad D. Udaidev S. Vaishnavi NG. Varun B. Vidya Shankar K. Vignesh NG. Vishal M. Yuvraj R. Thank you.
Thank you, madam. I now request Dr. E. Jeevaratnam Jain, the program head of BCom Corporate Secretaryship, to present her candidates.
Adarsh B. Abhishek V. Akash K. Anand M. Anish RL. Anita U. Balaji A. Balaji M. Gautam D. Hariharan B. Hariharan K. Hemant V. Herbert Simon A. Jaya Vignesh M. Pavan Kalyan. Karan M. Karthik M. Kavya Shri K. Kesav Ram A. Krishna K. Logesh S. Logesh SV. Madheshwaran V. Magesh S. Monish D. Narender M. Niroshan KB. Nitish Kumar J. Niveta R. Poker Darun Prabhudas. Pradeep S. Praveen Kumar G. Prince M. Rahul A. Rajesh Kannan M. Rajkumar V. Rangarajan T. Ruben K. Rupesh S. Sai Ganesh G. V. Sai Ram S. Sakti Roshni R. Saravanan S. Sindhil Kumar S. Seduram S. Sharmila S. N. Surya SP, Sivachan S, Surender U, Surya Prakash V, Swati N, Uday Shankar T, Yashwant, Vigneshwar K, Yatin Kumar R. Thank you.
Thank you, madam. Now, BCom General, I request Dr. Deepa Sridhar, the program head, to present her candidates. Madam, please.
Ajay Kumar S, Akash S, Anand G, Anik A, Ashwin R, Baijul Rahman R, Balagangan G, Dhanraj M, Dilip Kumar G, Ganesh Nirmal A, Hari P, Hari Prasad P, Kamal K, Kamali K, Karthikeyan Z, Kishore S, Kishore M, Kishore K, Lakshmi Bharti M, Lingesh D, Lingeshwaran K, Lokesh S, Madesh Deepan KR, Mageshwaran G, Maniganda Prabhu T, Meena M, Moideen Riaz N, Mukesh C, Nachiyappan M, Nagaraj E, Nirmal Kumar M, Bhumesh S, Pradeepa N, Pratap H, Pratish Kumar R, Pratibha M, Prem Kumar S, Prithiraj A, Rahul S, Rohit S, Vishendar MK, Sachin S, Sanjay RN, Sarath G, Saravanan SS, Sashikaran N, Sasikumar B, Sivaprakash M, Shrikant R, Srivatsan K. Surekha J. Suryakumar M. Surya V. Venkat Nagendran M. Venkatesh R. Vignesh K. Vigneshwar V. Wilson Solomon P. Yashwant E. Aarti Satish. Arsen R. Abhinesh A. Ajit J. Akash S. Arirajan S. Arivaragan S. Arun Saundar R. Babu P. Balabharani G. Balaji T. Bharatwaj MU. Bhuvanesh MG. Dharani K. Dineshwar K. Divya R. Ganesh R. Gopinath B. Harish H. Jagan PG. Jay Kishore S. Karthik K. Karthik N. Kaviarasan E. Kaushik M. Lalit Kumar BR. Manigandan D. Manoj B. Manoj Kumar M. Manoranjani M. Naveen Kumar R. Nimal Raj KK. Priyadashni R. Ramakrishnan R. Renuka T. Sabaresh A. Shaktivel S. Sanjay G. Sanjay K. Sanjay A. Santosh B. Saravanalingam G. Sivaraman C. Saurabh Gupta V. Srinivasan TG. Sujit Kumar PM. Sukumaran S. Suresh Kumar P. Surya Prakash A. Swati Priya R. Tamil Stalin ARB. Tyagarajan V. Uma Shankaran S. Veera Raghavan GA. Vinod Kumar R. Yadesh Kumar D. Yamini S. Yuvashankar K. Aditya Rajivan. Adnan Ali Raza. Arvid B. Asborn Yen. Ashok Kumar R. Avinash B. Badrinath I. Balram Krishnan. Bharatwajar. Deepak S. Dimalsan S. Dinesh Kumar U. Divya Prakash K. Divya Bharti R. Ganapati S. Gautam S. Arihara Sudhan S. Ariharan P. Kailash K. Karthik Hariharan. Kirti Vasan. Lalit B. Munish E. Navaneetha Krishnan R. Naveen S. Nirmal Kumar M. Nitesh Chaudhary D. Nitesh TKS. Batmanabhan K. Prasanna Raj V. Pratish S. Rahul Chauhan D. Rakesh AR. Roshan Kishore Singh S. Saluja Patra. Sanjay Menon M. Sanjay Chaudhary B. Santosh Kumar. Santosh Kumar G. Sai Prasanna CK. Sharan KPS. Sharveshwaran S. Suraj M. Sri Laya R. Sri Sai R. Subramanya Prasad S. Sundar R. Sunil Krishna N. Suresh K. Surya S. Swatika R. Udesh Milan U. Vamana H. Veluhari Abhishek A. Vignesh D. Vignesh G. Vignesh S. Vivek Kumar R. Yogesh K. Yuvanesh S. Kavin 11 P. Thank you.
Thank you, madam. Now it's BCom Bank Management. I request Ms. Maitreyi Venkatesh, the program head, to present her candidates. Madam, please.
Anbarasan B. Anish Kumar Y. Ansar Ali E. Balaji B. Balaji S. Bharat D. Deepak M. Deepak Kumar D. Gokul S. Gokulnath K. Gopi Krishnan B. Gautam Chand R. Gurumurti KR. Guru Prakash TS. Hariharan CS. Hariharan SK. Arish Kumar N. Arishwar S. Kamalesh B. Kirtana V. Kirtivasan B. Kiran R. Kishore J. Lokeshwaran E. Mahesh S. Manoranjita S. Mayarasan V. Monish Kumar S. Nagadivya V. Nagma A. Pramila J. Praneet S. Praveen Kumar S. Rahul K. Rajesh Khanna A. Ram Kumar S. Revan Kumar S. Rishabh R. Roshni K. Shahil Kumar Jain M. Sanjay Balu L. Sanjay P. Saravana Kumar K. Simona S. Sivanesh SS. Saundar Raj M. Shri Naveen Karthik S. Srinath S. Surya Prakash S. Tejaswin CP, Thirumaran R, Tyagarajan A, Veeradarshan S, Vignesh A, Yuvraj J. Thank you.
Thank you, madam. Now we'll speak on marketing management. I request Dr. S. Amarthalingam, the program head, to present his candidates. Sir, please.
Ajay Tandavil R, Akash K, Akash Shyam, Anushman Mishra, Ashwin Yen, Avi Chandogi, Karl Marx P, Dinesh V, Ganeshan N, Gopi V, Isai Mitran S, Jagan N, Jagat Rachagan, Kalai Kumaran R, Kavin S, Kavya R, Kavya J, Kripakaran S, Kaushik SPS, Krishna RV, Kumaran JE, Madhavan P, Praveen Rajkumar R, Rahul B, Rajkumar R, Sanjay M, Sanjay Kumar N, Sarat R, Shashwar Charan, Satish G, Shanmugasundaram S, Soundar Rajan R, Shriram V, Vijay S, Vimal Raj V, Vishnu Prakash, Yoga Prakash S, Yogesh R, Yokesh R. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Now, BCom Information System Management. I request Dr. Rabia K, the program head, to present her candidates.
Akila K, Amarnath S, Andu Marian, Anusha A, Arun S, Bharat M, Deshak E, Dinesh J, Dornala Venkata Sai Madhuvardhan, Isakki Revati R, Gopinath U, Gunashekaran D, Harishankar S, Hariprasad M, Hanasraj A, Ishan, Jawahar N. John David H. Kandavel A. Karan Ashwin B. Karthik B. Karthik C. Kartikeyan M. Kishore Kumar G. Lokesh B. Mohammed Raswan S. Naresh Kumar S. Naveen T. Naveen W. Praveen Kumar A. Roshini M. Charan P. Satvihan R. Shahrukh Ahmed P. Shankar R. Shivakaran. Shivakaran K. Shri Harish V. Sudarshan M. Suresh Aravind P. Uday Kumar C. Vasant S. Vasant T. Vinodini P. Viswanathan G. Viswa S. Yamini R. Yogesh D. And Yogesh D. Thank you.
And now it's BA English. I request Dr. A. Suganti Rao, the program head, to present her candidates. Madam, please.
Ajay Vidyasagar RB, Gobi Krishnan U, Harish Kumar EV, Kalki G, Karan B, Kaviyarasu S,
Dinesh.
Keetana G,
Dinesh, waiting.
Keeti K, Kinder S, Kausik Sudan K, Mahalakshmi G, Miss Pabi, Nalini P, Navadeepan S, Praveen Raj S, Priyadarshini A, Rahul Krishna MS, Ram Prakash R, Rishikesh R, Sagar Ahmed S, Saptishwar G, Sheshat Kumar S, Sibau Pamai, Subhashri, Sugan R, Susan Sweta R, Tamila, Tejas Kannan, Tanikai Velan, Varshini, Vasant Rajkumar R. Thank you.
Principal, to administer the pledge, which will duly be repeated by all the graduates. Madam, please.
I request all the graduates to kindly stand up and repeat the pledge. We shall
in thought, word, and deed,
ever endeavor
to be scrupulously honest
in the discharge of our duties
in our profession,
and shall uphold
the dignity and integrity
of our profession
and the honor of
our university.
We shall uphold
and advance
social order
and the well-being of
our fellow members
and shall devote
all our energy
to promote unity,
integrity,
and the secular ideal
of our country.
Please be seated.
By virtue of the authority vested in me as the principal of Guru Nanak College, I admit you to the several degrees for which you have been declared qualified, and in token whereof, I permit you to wear the academic robes ordained as the insignia of your degrees. I dissolve this graduation ceremony.
It's all rise for national anthem.
वाक्य विदादा पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा द्राविड उत्तर बंगा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्चल जलति तरंगा तब शुभ नामे जाहे तब शुभ आशीष माहे गाहे तब चले